Oh, good morning. Now, I'm not sure that you can actually hear me today. So will someone let me know? Will someone let me know if you can hear me or not? I don't think you can hear me. You should have got some music then at that point. But, I don't think you can hear me. Let's ask someone. I don't know why. What's that there? No. Is it that one? No, not that one. You can hear me. Okay. So it's only the music you couldn't hear, is it? Now, that's interesting. I'll have to work on that. Okay, we'll have to work on that. Good morning to you. It's Thursday the 26th of January 2017. I had a lovely new little opening there for you with a video and everything. And you saw the video, but you couldn't hear any music. How strange is that? How strange and mysterious is all that this morning? Yes. But never mind. Here we are. Congratulations today. First of all, congratulations to Adam this morning. Adam the plumber. Who has lost, get this, who has lost half a stone of weight. Yes, half a stone of weight in just 2 weeks and has become Slimmer of the Week at Slimmer's World or Weight Watchers, something like that. You must have a jingle, Adam, for that, my darling. You must have a jingle. Congratulations to Adam the Plumber. Well, I gotta say that just a minute. Got in music playing with flag. So you got that one, did you? But you didn't get the music over the countdown. Is that about right, Adam? I'll have to look into that. Okay. That's more tests to be run a little later on this afternoon. So congratulations. That is some. I don't know how you managed to lose half a stone in 2 weeks. There's a few of us that would like your advice, please. Please call in. Please call in and let us know how you're doing that, if you've got time, would you? 020-8144-3477. 020-8144-3477. Let's hello to the morning people. Good morning to Jerry Green. Morning to Danny Day, is it? Davies. Good morning, Danny. In Manchester, soon to move back to Wales, like the BBC News Channel. Oh, I'm so disappointed you didn't get the music. I really am. And yet you get the music for the flag. How strange. That is very strange. Good morning. Oh, good morning to Ronnie. Good morning, Ronnie. He's coming round later. When he appears, we disappear. Unfortunately, that's the way it works, because we're going to have our hair cut today and swimming as well. And I want to sort out that music. I'm really disappointed you didn't hear that music. That's really odd. There we go. Adam the Plumber. Good morning, Adam.
Morning, Chris. How are you?
All right. That's weird. So you got the normal bit with the little flag that comes out and the flames.
That's it. Yeah, and the music on the playback on that.
But you didn't get it for the 5 minute thing.
No, didn't get no playback. There was a bit of hissing, and then it tried to come in, I think, at one point, and then it disappeared again.
That's really strange. That is. Don't sound gonna have to make that all over again. But never mind. Whoa. More importantly, you, dear.
Yes.
How have you managed to lose half a stone of weight in just in 2 weeks?
By following the Slimming World diet, or lifestyle change, I should say.
And are you hungry most of the time?
I'm not hungry at all.
Really?
Far from it. In fact, sometimes I only eat twice a day now. Whereas before I was eating maybe 6-7 times a day.
And what have you managed to go on? Tell us how you managed to do this.
Completely cut fizzy drinks out. All fizzy drinks out. They've gone. All takeaway food and processed food is gone. Crisps, chocolate, everything like that.
Crisps. Crisps.
I know, Chris. I
no
know
crisps.
Why. But there are healthy options.
What? Healthy option is there in comparison to crisps, please?
Well, there would be those little potato chips, bananas, apples.
What potato
grapes.
Chips?
The what do they call them now? The sort of, I can't think what they're called now. I can't think of the name of them.
Are they the baked ones? Baked crisps?
Yeah.
Oh, my God, they're so dry, they are.
Mm-hmm.
Oh.
I mean, you can... I mean, as I say, it's certainly well that no food is a sin. You've just got to monitor what you take in, because they work it on a sin thing. So, for instance, I get 20 sins a day. So if I was to go out and...
You
have,
get what, dear?
Say it's done on sins.
Sins?
Done by sins.
Have you committed many then, dear? You want to go to confession if you committed sins, dear? A sin
I'm allowed 20 sins a day.
Right.
So, for instance, let's say I have a piece of white bread with butter. Ooh. That's 4 sins.
Is that all?
But if I have, let's say I have 2 slices of brown bread, that's part of my healthy option B. So that's okay, that's allowed.
2 slices of wholemeal bread is the same as one slice of white bread, is it?
Yeah, that's it, yep. And it's classed as your healthy option B. I'm still getting my head around all how it works, because there's a book that comes with it, and there's things like speed food.
You have to read as well?
There's a little booklet, and I think also what helps is that when you go to the actual swimming world class every week, you know, you get all the encouragement and help, and there's people there, you know, saying what you should be doing and what you shouldn't be doing. Right. And it's all sort of very, very encouraging. It's sort of, you know, and Adam has lost 4.5 pounds this week, and it really gives you a round of applause and what have you.
That is excellent. It's all
really good. It's well worth it. I mean, most of my friends I've spoken to that have been on it have lost between 4 and 5 stone in a year.
Oh, that's excellent. Oh, I need to lose 10 stone immediately. I want to be 4 stone in weight.
I mean, there is an app. Slimming World app. And that will sort of give you an idea of where...
Let me write this down. Slimming World app.
Yep, Slimming World app. And that gives you an idea of what food values are, as in sins. There is also another little app as well, which I use, which is really handy. And that sort of gives you the traffic light system that you get with foods.
Yes.
It sort of gives you an idea of how much fat and how much salt and stuff like that is in the in the foods. And it's called My Fitness Pal, P-A-L.
My Fitness Pal. Oh, mind you, they've all got that printed on the boxes anyway, haven't they, you generally? Yes.
Well, they have, but be careful, because, for example... let me just grab an old wrapper from something.
Come back towards the phone, dear.
I am. Oh, I was just leaning over to grab an old wrapper that I had. I've kept this candy bar wrapper to give you an example.
What do you mean, candy bar?
Oh, sorry, chocolate bar.
Have we become one of the states of the United States suddenly, dear?
It's
not a candy bar. And it's not. And when you go to Subway, it's not a sub, it's a roll. It's a roll, dear. So don't ever say candy bar on this programme, dear.
Well, I'm translating for your American viewers across the pond.
I happen to know that Donald Trump has requested that not Margaret Thatcher, she's gone, isn't she? Theresa May has been requested to take him over proper Galaxy English chocolate, dear. So much better than the Cadbury stuff now, lovey. That's all gone terribly wrong. What a shame.
It is.
Can you have chocolate? How many Sims is a large bar of Galaxy Dairy Milk chocolate?
Well, I think that would take you through the roof. Let's have a look, shall we?
Yes.
You can get it up on the...
Oh, get it in your
little
book, dear. Oh, she's got a diary there as well. Look at that.
Yep, let's have a look. Now, let's see. Swimming World, and then we'll go to food.
Yes.
Food search.
Can't understand. It's doing my head in why you couldn't hear that music.
No.
Because the little meter was going up and down like that. Very, very strange and mysterious.
Was the slider not up for the output?
Yeah, the meter was going up. I could see it going out, and yet you couldn't hear it.
All right.
Excuse me. How strange and mysterious. That's doing my head in now. I'm going to have to sort that out.
So we want a Galaxy chocolate bar.
Yes.
Let's have a look. Galaxy.
What's a Galaxy chocolate bar, dear?
Let's have a look, see if it comes up. See if I can get it loading.
Yeah.
Right. Galaxy chocolate bar. Hold on.
Sorry?
Exactly. Galaxy.
In your own time, darling.
Well, I'm dyslexic. I'm taking my time to load it in.
Come along, dear. Chop, 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 chop.
It would be about five sins.
Five sins for a large bar of Galaxy. Well,
for a small bar. For a large bar, you'll be talking about 25 sins.
Ah, so that's more than your usual sims per day.
Yes.
Well, I think I'd like to try this, Danny. Adam.
Yes, indeed.
I would like to try this. Have I got to join something?
Well, you can join your local slimming world, yes. You just go once a week. Or you can probably, I should imagine if you go onto the website, you can probably maybe order the book.
Yes, okay, I'll do that. I think I'll try that.
Have a look on the Slimming World app and see if there is a book available. If not, I can lend you my one.
Okay.
Lend you my one.
I will
And see how we go. But, I mean, it's basically about monitoring what you... The best thing to do as well, another thing to do, is write down what you have to eat every day.
I've got a little diary here. I've got a church diary, dear. And funnily enough, look, I started that yesterday. So, for example, yesterday I had bran flakes with blueberries. Mm-hmm. For the lunch, I had a veggie burger with cheese and some Angel Delight.
Yep.
And when I came back at night, I had... A bowl of tomato soup, one slice of wholemeal bread. Oh, and crisps.
Okay.
Sounds only good. One, but so that was actually quite a good day yesterday. So if I can just stick to this thing, I'm going to try this. I'm going to get that book.
Well, here we go. Here's an example for you: bran flakes.
Bran flakes, yes.
Are four sins per 25 grams.
Oh, that's quite a lot, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Four sims, and you're allowed 20 a day.
Allowed 20 a day. So, for instance, bran flakes. And I'm just trying to see if they've got if they have Waitrose ones listed. Waitrose essential bran flakes.
Of course.
Yeah, four sins is 25 grams.
So it's I've got to weigh stuff as well. See, I just usually fill the bowl up, dear.
If you go for the whole grain.
Yeah.
Bran flakes in Waitrose.
That's what I have,
That's 7.5 sins. That is one of your healthy options.
Well, that's more sins.
It's more sins, but it is actually one of your healthy options, which means that it will fill you up more for the rest of the day.
It sounds very, very complicated to me, dear.
Well, once you get onto the app, download the app, the Slimming World app, have a look at it. And it should give you some ideas, and see if there's a local group nearby you that you can go to on one of your nights off. It's only a couple of hours, and it's really, really good, really encouraging.
So
I think
why would I want to go to a group and not just open the book and read it?
Because the group will help you. It will encourage you to lose the weight. Because there's a group, it's a support network. It's not only about losing the weight by changing what you eat.
Yes.
It's also the psychological side of it and people being supportive of what you're going through because everybody else is going through the same. I mean, in my group, there are about 50.
Oh, quite a lot of people. That's a lot of people, isn't it?
Yeah, and there's two groups. There's one at 5:30 and there's one at 7:30. I go to the 7:30 one.
Okay.
Because of work. And basically, you get all the support from everybody. They've got a closed Facebook group. Like, for instance, I said to the, I put in the Facebook group, help, I'm dyslexic. Can you help me, fill out my diary? And with that, when I got there yesterday, there was five people waiting to help me fill out my diary.
And were any of them nice?
They're all nice ladies, they're all nice ladies.
Oh, no one to chat up then, dear.
Well, there might be. I don't know. It depends, who comes along next week.
Oh, Adam, well, congratulations and keep at it. I'm very, very impressed, dear.
Thank you. And one other thing as well is drink plenty of water because a lot of people don't realise that hunger can also be triggered by thirst.
Yes, yes, I've seen that several times. There's a lot of people that say, have a glass of water before lunch and you won't eat so much.
That's right, yeah.
Yeah, very good advice there, Adam. Well, keep Thank us you, Chris. Fully informed. Yep. I want at least a phone call a week from you, dear, informing us of how well you're doing. And also, if you kind of fall off the wagon a little bit, we want to hear about that as well. All
exactly.
the nitty gritty details, please, Adam the plumber.
I will do. Thanks, Chris.
Thank you for dialing into our circuits this morning.
Thank you. Goodbye.
Cheerio, Adam. Adam the plumber, well, that is to be commended, isn't it, really? All that weight lost in such a short space of time, fantastic. Absolutely, I'm going to give that a go, good morning to Carl, and let's have a look. Jerry Green, good morning, Jerry. Mark's there, good morning, Mark. And yes, so I don't know why we didn't get the music right at the beginning there. That's actually confusing me, why that happened. I'm really not sure why that happened. Good morning to Danny Davis calling from Manchester. Good morning, Danny.
Good morning. How is everyone?
Good morning. Good morning. Make your day a sun-blessed day. It's so full of goodness for you, 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 you. Morning, Danny. Have you been on a weight loss thing?
Well, I did lose a considerable amount of weight when we spoke, was it about 6 weeks ago? I lost half a stone, if you remember.
No, I don't remember now. How did you do that? Were you ill?
No.
That's a good way to lose weight. Just find someone who's got flu and go and sit with them for an hour.
No, portion control is the big thing.
Oh, portion control. That's the thing with me, dear. You know, I'm not happy unless that plate is full up like a little mountain. You know, my plate looks bigger than Everest sometimes. I can't lie to you, Danny. It's bigger than Everest.
You can, like Adam said, you can do your sins and you can turn to healthy food, but that works, but also have portion control. So if you have things, control how much of it you're eating.
Is it like, for example, if I'm having a salad, I would have like one piece of lettuce instead of three?
Well, that's healthy. So if you say you had,
oh,
I don't know.
What about if I usually have 1.5 tomatoes, if I only have half a tomato?
Yeah, things like that. So cutting down the size of what you're eating. So instead, say you buy a big bag of chips, have a smaller portion.
What, and chuck those chips away? It's a terrible waste. Mind you, there's a lot of birds around here like to peck the food up as I chuck it out into the garden for them. I am a great friend of wildlife, as you know. No dead animals pass these lips, thank you very much.
But portion control is the biggest thing. And I did, when I did lose the half a stone, I kind of put, I'd say, a quarter of it back on.
Oh,
so.
Dear. And why was that? Because your portions went bigger again?
No, it was because I come off nights and then I started working days and then obviously my
metabolism
started come back, yeah.
Oh,
so when you work through the night, your appetite is like kind of non-existent. So I was getting up 5 o'clock in the afternoon, having something to eat, and then maybe having a sandwich in work, and then I wouldn't eat then until I got up the next the next day, effectively.
Oh, that's too much, isn't it, dear? Never mind. You can lose it again if you want to.
Well, I won't be eating all these pies, let's say that.
Well, you're working at Greg's, dear. You're going to be... Are you there yet? When do you start?
I start on Monday.
Oh, so have you moved back to Wrexham yet?
I moved, but I did it all yesterday. That's the reason why I wasn't that's why I wasn't on yesterday's live show.
So you're back in Welsh Wales now?
Yes, I'm back in Welsh
Wales. I'm wondering, if you was to take in, like, you know, a Bluetooth speaker... You could have this show playing out in your shop. Perhaps I could be rolled out across the Greg's network. You know, screens would be put in all the Greg's, showing my show as it is beamed directly here from the Mirrable Studio in Royal Berkshire. What do you think of that idea, Danny?
I'll pop it to head office and see what they say.
I think you should. Well, won't be long before you're running the entire organisation. I'm very sure, dear.
But yes, if it was up to me, I'd put you on.
Thank you, Danny.
I'd put you on my shop.
Well, thank you for letting us know about your weight loss thing as well. I appreciate that.
Thank you. Take care, Chris.
Cheerio.
Bye. Bye-bye.
Bye, Danny. Oh, get down to Greg's in Wrexham soon. Mention United Kingdom Talk for your free cheese and onion pasty. Mmm. And you get back £1.30. It's very cheap in there. Good morning to Ross Patsout, who says, I've got you on in the canteen. What canteen, dear? What, you mean your kitchen or the canteen at work? In Tesco's? Am I on a large screen in Tesco's? Actually, Tesco's, years ago, I bought a flat screen telly from Tesco's and, you know, the usual 1 year guarantee. And about month 14, it packed up completely, wouldn't come on. And I wrote to them and I said, I know I'm out of guarantee. And I think the telly at the time was about 300 quid. You get much cheaper now. It was about 300 quid. And I wrote to them, I know the guarantee has run out, but I bought this telly from you. It's 14 months old and it's gone wrong. Is there anything you can do? And with that, they sent me a cheque for 250 quid. That's good, isn't it? Very good. Top marks for Tesco's there. Good morning to Gustav. When he says a packet of crisps, it's the family bag or a buy one, get one free. Oh, well, that's okay then. I've got a buy one. Oh, no, I've told you now. I've told you, I was tempted last night on the way home from an excellent quiz night last night. We weren't over busy last night. We had six teams all together. But on our way home from on my way home from the quiz last night, I did stop at the BP garage. I wanted washing up liquid. Completely run out of washing up liquid. But while I was in there, I'm afraid I bought two bags of Walker's cheese and onion crisp, but not the big ones. The grab-sized ones, which are the old normal size. So they made the normal size ones even smaller because they like to make things smaller, don't they, to make more money. So the medium ones are probably the same size as the small ones used to be, aren't they? So I had two bags of those, but I only ate one bag. So I'm quite pleased when I got in last night. I had that and a bowl of soup, nice tomato soup and a piece of bread. So that was me last night. Ronnie says it's the portions. Angel Delight is for four, not one. Oh yes, we did make Angel Delight yesterday. I know I still haven't done the video, and it worked. I made it with normal milk, as advised by one of our listeners yesterday. As advised. You see, you give me the advice, I take your advice. I take your advice. As advised, I made it with normal milk, whisked it up, and within minutes it had solidified. Oh, it was delicious. But interestingly enough, when I made it with the soya milk and it wouldn't solidify, so it was like a milkshake, a very, very tasty milkshake, I must say, but nevertheless, it was a milkshake and not a solid thing. And I was able to drink all of it, no problem. When it's gone solid, you can only eat half of it. Isn't that strange and mysterious? Yes, it is. Very strange and mysterious. So I've got another half of that in the fridge, which I hope that's okay to have 24 hours later. It has been in the fridge. What do you reckon, ladies? What is your advice, please? I am asking your advice on how. How? Do you remember that programme from Southern Television? Dun, 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 dun. You remember that? How? With Fred Dinage. Now, Fred Dinage is still a TV presenter on Meridian. He does South Today, or I don't know what it's called, actually. The programme in the South. You know, the one that comes after the news, like a magazine show. Yeah, he's still on the telly. He must be nearly 80 years old. Good old Fred Dinage is there. Good morning to Mr. Ray Reynolds. Morning, Ray, who says, great quiz last night. Yes, it was. What a shame you came fourth. Was it fourth or third you came last night? Ray Reynolds appeared last night with our man from ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba, Essex Radio. Pete Ward was there last night. And he's a lovely man, Pete Ward. Now, what was he saying to me last night? Did I make a note about Pete Ward? There was Pete and there was Ray and another bloke. I can't remember the other bloke. But, that was it. So I was talking to Pete last night. Now, he does a little radio show on a small station in Essex. I reckon it's hospital radio he does. There's nothing wrong with hospital radio. But, you know, honestly, Pete, lovey, don't be telling us you do a big show on an FM station, darling, when really you're on hospital radio. Ba-da-ba-ba-ba, hospital radio, Basildon, with Pete Ward. Is that what you do, lovey? Is for someone who does a music radio show, you're not very good at the music round, are you, dear? You don't seem to know anything. Very, very disappointed. Anyway, Pete, have you ever done online radio? Oh, it's very liberating because you get away with anything. Do anything you want. There's no rules. You say whatever you want. You can even swear if you want to because you look that sort of... I reckon you're a little bit of a potty mouth, really, aren't you, my lovey? Eh? Eh? Do you swear a lot? I think you might swear a lot. If you do internet radio, that's good. You'd do anything. I used to do internet. I've done several stations, actually. Anyway, Pete and I were chatting last night. I said, Pete, I want to ask you something. You know before you go on air? And he said, yes. Because he's on the station at a time when there's not many other people are in the station at that time. You know, it's a quiet period within the building that they do the show. In the hospital. It's a quiet time in the casualty unit in the hospital at the hospital radio station that he works at. And I was saying to him last night, do you start counting down things? You know, before, like, the mic comes on and the camera comes on and all that. Do you start counting down things? And he's like, well, what do you mean? I said, well, sometimes I'm sitting in the studio there and I'm watching my countdown going down like that. And I start counting. Stand by, studio. Stand by, everyone. 10 seconds still on air. 9, 8. And I said, and I do it, but there's no one here. You know, I'm talking to him. And he started laughing and said, yeah, I do that as well. So I reckon they all do it. I bet Tony Blackburn does it. Stand by, everyone. Stand by. And there's no one there. You're talking to yourself. Why do we do that? Isn't that strange and mysterious? So, oh my God, I nearly went off of my chair then. Very, very strange. Some more messages. Good morning to Elaine. Elaine's with us from Israel. Good morning, Elaine. My sister's with us today, Sharon. Oh, you're up early, aren't you? Mind you, my sister, she's up. She gets up earlier now than she used to. Because my sister, I don't know if you know this, she used to do a show on Babe Station. Yep, she had her own little show on Babe Station, although they used to put her on very late at night because not many people used to call her up until they were drunk. And in fact, it did get to the point, it got to the point, this is a while ago now, it got to the point that she got sacked from Babe Station because no one was calling her. You know, which is, you know, they seem to call the other girls, but not my sister for some reason. So she got sacked from Babe Station. But she's with us this morning. She says, how many sin do you have in a day? 20. 20, Adam was saying, Sharon, 20 sins per day. You're allowed to sin 20 times now before you go to confession. Yes. Oh, dear. Let's have a look at these messages and we'll do some a little bit of news for you. Good morning to Alan Russell. Morning, Alan. Who says it's snowing in Hackney. There's no snow. There's no snow in Hackney. Probably what it is someone's lit a fire somewhere and it's ash coming down. Have you got a volcano in Hackney? Eh? Is there a volcano in Hackney? That's probably what it is. Ash coming down from the sky, dear. Adam, oh my word. Adam says 59 grams of Angel Delight is 13 and a half sins. 13 and a half, dear. That's half your sins of the day. Oh, well. Good morning to William Broughton. He's in Australia. Morning, William. Lovely bit of singing for you this morning, William. I did see your little Facebook post. He's hoping to represent Australia. Probably not this year. My guess is they've chosen the person this year. Hoping to represent Australia in the Eurovision Song Contest. Aren't you, my lovey? Eurovision Song Contest, dear. What do you mean they're not in Europe? We know Australia are not in Europe, but they're nice people, dear. They're nice people. It's like saying the United Kingdom is part of Europe. And it's not, dear. We're the United Kingdom. Thank you very much. Jerry says, I used to watch How in the 90s. Ah, well, in the 90s, it was made by Television South because Southern lost their franchise years ago. Oh, it's a long time ago now. And then TVS took that over and it was made by TVS at that point, I think, which then became Meridian. And then it all went wrong and ITV just become one large faceless company now, I'm afraid. Adam says, a Greg cheese and bacon pasty is 19 sins. That's one thing. 19 sins. I've got to get that booklet. I must get... I wonder. Let's have a quick look on Amazon. I've got the old one-click ordering set up. Don't you worry about that. Amazon. Slimmer's World. Let's have a look. I was going to buy another webcam. I don't know why. There's nothing wrong with this one, is it? Slimmer's... But does it, can anyone find out for me what webcams did the BBC use? Not, obviously, not cameras that they use on their... But a lot of the shows now have webcams, and they look quite good. Does anyone know what webcams the BBC use? Right. Slimmer's World Sins. Let's see what comes up. No. Well, I can't see that one. Slimmer's World Slims... Oh, I'll tell you where I might have it. Oh, wait. Food optimizing. What's that? Hang on a minute. Haven't food the satisfying weight to lose with 120. Oh, that's a recipe book. That is. Let's try eBay. eBay. The trouble is, by buying some sort of food book from eBay, there's probably people have touched it. You know, got bits of food on the book, haven't they? So, Slimmer's World Sins book. Let's see what comes up there. Nothing. Now, Adam, I wonder if you could post up the title of the book. I'll try and search for it like that, because I'm not getting anything come up there, unfortunately. Yes. Ross says, are you a fan of the Crystal Maze, as they have a venue in London where you can play the actual game? Would you go to it? Oh, no, dear. No. That's far too much exercise in one day. Running around that thing, looking for little bits and bits. The last time I went running around, not physically, a room looking for things, was a game called Attic Attack. Do you remember that? It was on the Sinclair Spectrum with a little tape. As it went into the machine. And you'd have to do it about five times before it was work. Yes. Dreadful thing. Let's have a look here. Oh, Adam's going to try and get me a book. Thank you very much. If you could do that. If you could do that for me, Adam, can you try and get me one of those books? And then I can do something about it. All right, my love? Now, have you ever sent someone a text message and it's the wrong person? This is in this morning's Super Soraway Daily Sun. Oh, yes. No one likes that sinking feeling when you know you've sent a message to the wrong person and that pit of your stomach ache even gets worse if you then accidentally sent off something saucy. Have you had saucy text? I don't think I've ever had a saucy text message. Please, can I have one now? Why don't I get any of these? And I never got invited to any of those type of parties. Why is that? Anyway, these careless texters did just that, but the pain was probably worth it in exchange for the responses they got from their witty recipients. I like that word. Do you like that word? Recipients. Yes. Isn't that an interesting fact? Prepare for some belly laughs as we present the most hilarious replies received in response to the wrong number of messages. So here we go. Here we go. Message number one. Hi, Kevin. It's Ashley. I've been trying to get a hold of you. Your brother gave me your new number. I really wanted to apologise for... in your car. I'll buy new upholstery or pay to have it shampooed if needed. I'm so embarrassed. LOL. Wrong number. Is the reply. Hey, Mary. Need to come in for a haircut. Let me know a time. Thanks. Jeff. Will either of these styles do? They start sending funny pictures because it's the wrong number. It's not a hairdresser. Let's have a look. Actually, these aren't funny, are they? Oh, here's one. Hi, baby. I'm just chilling. You want to come over? And there's a picture of a topless man, like, and he's like this, you know, looking all butch. And then her brother replies, she gave you the wrong number. How awful. Here's another one. Your father just died. Reply. Took him long enough. He's been buried since 1994. Reply. You're rude. All you had to say was wrong number. Reply. No, you are rude. If someone dad dies, they actually deserve an actual phone call, not an effing text. That's true, isn't it? That's true. Here's another one. You are literally one of the most beautiful women I have ever laid my eyes on. Send me nudes. I sent a picture of a bloke. So here we are. Always be careful that you don't send the right text to the wrong person. And don't forget, if you want to send me any saucy texts or messages later on, I would most appreciate that. That would be very nice. Thank you very much, boys and girls. Right, let's do today's... Alan says I'll send you some messages later. Thank you very much. Thank you, Alan. I look forward to that. We're going to do today's birthdays now because my mate will be around soon and we're going over to the to get our haircuts today. Oh, hang on a minute. The messages from yesterday's show. I did have those here somewhere. Now, where are they? One moment, please. Messages that you put on this yesterday's show where the videos come up there. From, if I can find these, where are they now? There we go. There we are. John Child. Good morning, John. It was his birthday at the weekend, wasn't it? He says, I'm tempted to watch these shows, but I've been downloading shows to use as podcasts on my journey into town. And if I watch this, I will have nothing to listen to tomorrow morning. No, you wait. Hang on a minute. Is that the right date? Yeah, that's the right one. Yes, very good, John. You wait until it's time for you to drive in. I hope you don't watch the show in your car, dear. Turn the phone up the other way. But this show, we used to do an audio-only version, actually. We did do that for quite so many years. Simon says on the subject of the TV show Silent Witness, last night it was very good and very clever. What they do is, well, and it's very hard to get away with murder in England. Oh, I don't know. I've knocked a few people off myself. You know, when people cross me, I just send someone round. I've never been caught yet. Thank you, John. Thank you, Simon, who says... Jackie Evans says, thank you for not telling everyone how old I was yesterday. That's okay, Jackie. That's okay. Simon says, why don't you do stand-up comedy in places like Comedy Store? You'd be very good at that. No, I don't agree, Simon. Not at all. I really do not think that's one thing. So, you know, I actually have a very low opinion of myself. I always have done. But definitely stand-up comedy, that's not something that is easy to do. It really isn't. I mean, you've literally got to stand there. And if they're not laughing, you've got to carry on. What if they don't laugh? You know, you can't stop. That is not something I'd be good at. I'm sure you've got to be a very particular type of person to be able to do that. Danny says, I've been to the Hilton Hotel several times. Had Gadio's 10th birthday in Cloud 23. What's that? The cocktail bar in the sky. It's awfully tall. Oh, and finally, Gustav says, Chris, darling, I'm thinking of heading to your wonderful karaoke night tomorrow. Please clear up an issue. Is the offer of giving your bum a squeeze still valid? I'm tempted to do it one more time. Of course, dear. You feel free to squeeze my little bottom. My minuscule bottom, anytime you want to, as I float past you while collecting pens. I'd be so careful at collecting pens at these karaoke nights. People steal my pens. Thieves. Ray Reynolds is the worst one. He's the worst offender. He's always, you watch him walking around, and he keeps grabbing people and forcing them to listen to jokes. He does. And at the same time, steals their pen. So, yes, you may have a squeeze on anyone else, all right? Today's birthday, son. Happy birthday to Perry. Hello, Perry. Oh, my favourite doorman from the Two Brewers. 53 today. Happy birthday, Perry. Happy birthday to Peter Fraser. Hello, Peter. Nice boy, Peter Fraser. Richard Davies is 48 today. Stephen Biles. Hello, sir. 37 years old today. Happy birthday, Stephen. Happy birthday. I always remember these people. I do remember you. Buffy Sheena is 29 today, and Aja Kelly is 30 years old today. Let's do our little song game. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, happy birthday. Happy birthday to you. Enjoy your birthday on this Thursday. Right, I'm off to get my hair cut now and have a little swim and probably pop into Marks and Spencer's for some shopping as well. Thank you very much for watching and listening. I shall be working on the video later, so you might see some tests come up on Facebook to see if we can get the music playing on that new kit. I'm so disappointed. I was up till about half past two sorting that out last night and it's not worked, but never mind. See you again soon. Thanks very much for watching. Bye-bye now.